inspectors continue to look into Phantom's Revenge. That's the Kennywood ride, which stopped in mid-air yesterday. And goodness, the good news here, no one was hurt.
All right, so tonight, the State Department of Agriculture says the ride is 100% safe. But as Channel 4 Action News investigator Bofta Umam explains, the latest inspection report is kind of skimpy on the details, Bofta.
Extremely skimpy, Wendy. Kennywood refused to allow us on their property to discuss inspection procedure. And the Department of Agriculture, who inspects these rides, says this is the latest Phantom's Revenge inspection report. Let's pull it up for you. It was completed early this month. Take a look. You can see it doesn't say much. No description about their inspection. And when we probed about details, they said it passed inspection and nothing had been redacted from this document. We also asked for the entire park's latest inspection report, but they could not provide that by our deadline request. Right now, we still don't know what went wrong on the Phantom's Revenge ride yesterday. Now, the Department of Agriculture says the preliminary investigation shows the safety system detected an issue that needs to be checked into. But they say the safety system did work because it stopped the ride in a safe position. The ride was back up in an hour yesterday, and state inspectors were back out there today. Now, yesterday, riders on the Phantom's Revenge were walked down after the sensor malfunctioned. Kennywood tells Channel 4 Action News, in part, we had the option to let the riders sit in the train while we addressed the issue, but decided to walk them down the lift staircase since they were on the lower portion of the lift and we knew it would take a little time to fix. Kennywood has daily inspections with certified inspectors who are their own employees, but the state does perform unannounced inspections too. We're going to continue to follow this investigation. Make sure you stay with Channel 4 Action News. Live in the newsroom, both team on Channel 4 Action News. Both